underneath the Mexican sky. Drink some margaritas, watch neon blue lights. Listen to the mariachi play at midnight. Are you with me? Are you with me?
It is currently 4 a.m. and we're on our way, guys. We're going to Yokohama, Japan today. I'm so excited. I'm going to bring you guys on the trip. But now I'm going to rush because I'm going to miss this train. Anyways, I saw this really funny scene on the runway. It was this little van trying to pull a whole plane by itself, and I was like cheering it on. The flight to Tokyo took around 9 hours. It was absolutely amazing in the sky. There was like no turbulence at all. And the place I stayed at in Yokohama actually took me by surprise. It is so bougie looking. This was my room. Look how nice it is. Let me show you the view. Come on, it does not get better than this. This was definitely one of my most spontaneous trips. All thanks to Bemco, we were able to have a spectator pass to spectate it live in the venue. And the venue was absolutely massive. It included Pokemon TCG, Pokemon VGC, Pokemon Go, and obviously Pokemon Unite. Unite itself had 4 stages. There were 2 comp stages, 1 B stage, and the main stage as well. Now, with almost 30 teams competing, you could see fans everywhere cheering the teams on. As a Luminosity fan, I was very, very happy that they won for the second year straight. They won on this incredible 13-1 streak. It is actually really insane what they can do live on stage, and it really inspires me to be a better player myself. Now, where do all Pokemon fans love to go? The Pokemon Center. I'm not even going to say anything in this next bit. Just sit back and enjoy the Pokemon plushies. Hey guys, so just finished going to the Pokemon Center and I'm currently trying to lug 2 bagfuls of Pokemon plush back home. It is
a lot of Pokemon, I know, but it doesn't stop there. In Japan, most things have a Pokemon variant, including food as well. So I got an opportunity, thank you to Nizvan, to go to a Pokemon cafe and just have a look at these wonderful dishes. So I got the Snorlax with the chicken, beautiful. There was Eevee and Chowder. Every single form of food, there was some sort of Pokemon association. Like this was cake with Jell-O inside, and it had more rice with a Quaxly drink. They even had this menu where you could order any Pokemon in terms of a latte art, and they will bring it out with that Pokemon on your coffee. While I was in Japan, I wanted to try out as many different dishes as possible for my meals of the day. Obviously, I had a lot of sushi. It is incredibly fresh over there. But I also had the different types of ramen possible. I had a rolled up ice cream. I had a lot of curry. Curry there is actually fantastic. One of my favorite places we went was this sushi train, where the dishes would come on top of this electronic train. And after you take your dishes, you would send the little train back by pressing the red button. I had a couple more days left in Tokyo, so I went up to the Tokyo Skytree with the EXO crew. Beautiful night scene. It's very hard to record in there, but you could see the entire Tokyo basically and all the lights. I went to the iconic Shibuya crossing, and they actually had a room there with 2 rooms, in fact, with just gacha machines that filled out the entire place. I think gacha machines must be their pokies or something over there, because it is so accessible. Everywhere you go, there are gacha machines. So if you got coins, you know where that's going. Speaking of coins, when I went to the Sensoji Temple in Tokyo, at the end of the street, you could actually do kind of like a DIY fortune teller thing, where if you put in your 100 yen, you get to shake a box that drops a stick with a number on it. And depending on what number you've got, they will give you kind of like a fortune reading. And your boy got regular fortune. I don't know what that means. But I must have been lucky enough because my friends and I found ourselves at the maid cafe the next day. This Japan trip has been nothing but amazing. I think the biggest highlight for me was just meeting everybody. Friends that I've made online that live across the world I got to see in person. I think it's really special when a group of people come together that share the same passion. The connection is just so genuine and so great. Just like this stranger that I saw in a train station playing the Pokemon theme song on a public piano. There is just nothing more that can encapsulate my time in Japan.
Catch 'em all.